نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم اما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى كما ورد في آخر سورة مريم سلام عليها اعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وقالوا اتخذ الرحمن ولدا and they say that Rahman, the compassionate, Allah has taken a son to him. لَقَدْ جَيْتُمْ شَيْئًا إِدَّا You have come up, you have brought a thing which is very terrible in the eyes of Allah. تَقَادُ السَّمَاوَاتُ يَتَفَتَّرْنَ مِنْهُ The heavens are near to burst. وَتَنْشَقُّ الْأَرْضُ And the earth is near to split asunder. وَتَخِرُّ الْجِبَالُ هَدَّا And the mountains are near to fall down in ruins. أَنْدَعَوْ لِلْرَّحْمَانِ وَلَدًا That they should ascribe to the compassionate a son. وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِلْرَّحْمَانِ أَنْ يَتَّخِذَ وَلَدًا And it doesn't behove for the compassionate, for Rahman, that he should have a son for him. Now what's the meaning of this ayah? We like to have sons, why? Because we know we shall die. And our name will be remembered through our sons. This is our necessity. We know that we have to die. We shall be no more. But Allah is not going to die. He will remain forever, forever, forever. There's no need. What is the need for him to have sons or daughters? He is himself alive. Al-Hayyul Qayyum. La yamutu abadan abada. He's not going to die. So actually, this concept of some sons or daughters for Allah is absolutely illogical. وَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِلْرَّحْمَانِ أَنْ يَتَّخِذَ وَلَدًا It doesn't behove for the compassionate Allah to have a son to himself. إِنْ كُلُّ مَنْ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ إِلَّا آتِي الرَّحْمَانِ عَبْدًا There is no one in all the heavens and the earth, but he will come to him as a bondsman. Maybe Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When he comes there, he'll be a bondsman. وَنَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ His relationship of abdiyah towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is more important than his relationship of messengerhood. That is why I ask you to note that Suratul Isra or Bani Israel starts with this abd. سُبْحَانَ الَّذِي أَسْرَى بِعَبْدِهِ لَيْلًا مِنَ الْمَسْجِدِ الْحَرَامِ إِلَى الْمَسْجِدِ الْأَقْصَى Not Rasulihi. In the same way, Surah Qahf starts, أَلْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ الَّذِي أَنزَلَ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ الْكِتَابَ وَلَمْ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ عِوَجًا Then Surah Al-Furqan will come, تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي نَزَّلَ الْفُرْقَانَ عَلَى عَبْدِهِ لِيَكُونَ لِلْعَالَمِينَ نَصِيرًا This abdiyat. So everybody will come to him, whether an angel or a saint or a prophet or a messenger, all are his bondsmen, all are his creation. لَقَدْ أَحْصَاهُمْ وَعَدَّهُمْ عَدَّا We have comprehended them all and we have counted them. Each one will have to come before us. وَكُلَّهُمْ آتِيهَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْضًا This is very important ayah. And all of them will have to be present on the day of judgment as an individual. Your father will not be there to help you. Your sons will not be there to help you. Your spouses will not be there to help you. Your servants, your slaves, none farda. And the accountability of the day of judgment is individual. The nations are rewarded in this world. The chastisement to the nations at the collective level comes here. Just as we have seen the chastisement that came to the former Muslim Ummah at the hands of the Assyrians, at the hands of the Babylonians, at the hands of the Greeks, at the hands of the Romans, and in this century at the hands of the Germans, what Hitler did with them. So this collective accountability of nations, it is in this world. On the day of judgment, each one will be judged as an individual. What we gave you and what you made out of it. What you have brought with you. Good deeds, bad deeds. Where's your balance sheet? اقرا کتابک کفا بنفسک الیوم علیک حسیبا. We have read this ayah in Surah Bani Israel. Now you read your balance sheet yourself. You are sufficient for reckoning. There's no need of any other accountant. وَكُلَّهُمْ آتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدًّا. Whereas those who came to believe and did good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assign for them the love. People will love them. A time will come. You know, people were persecuting Muhammad for some time. But can you count the lovers of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam today? How many people love Muhammad? Just imagine. So for those people, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala announces, there's a hadith of Qudsi. When Allah loves someone, He makes an announcement in the angels, I love that human being, so you also love them. And then the angels proclaim to the people, Allah loves such and such person, you should also love them. So people love them. But in the beginning they are tested. The tests come to them. They have to pass the examination. وَإِذِبْتَلَىٰ إِبْرَاهِيمَ رَبَّهُ بَكَلِمَاتٍ فَاتَمَّهُنَّ. When we tested Ibrahim in so many things, and he fulfilled all, then we said, Inni ja'iluka linnasi imama. Now, oh Ibrahim, I am going to make you the imam and leader of the whole of mankind. So after that testing, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sayaj'alu lahumur rahmanu wudda. Assign love for them. Fainnama yassarnahu bilisanika. We have made this Quran very easy, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in your tongue. Simple Arabic. Arabiyin mubeen. Very clear, simple Arabic. لِتُبَشِّرَ بِهِ الْمُتَّقِينَ. So that you give the glad tidings with this Quran to those who are God-fearing. وَتُنْزِرَ بِهِ قَوْمًا لُدَّا. And you warn those people who are quarrelsome, who are arguing, who are not accepting, who are disputing. So you are a warner to them and the giver of glad tidings to those who take to the right path. وَكَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ. How many a generation we have destroyed before them. Where is now the nation of Aad? Where is that nation of Samud? Where are the grand cities of Sodom and Gomorrah and Madian? Gone. Gone with the wind. كَمْ أَهْلَكْنَا قَبْلَهُمْ مِنْ قَرْنٍ. هَلْ تُحِسُّ مِنْهُمْ مِنْ أَحَدٍ. Do you perceive anyone of them? Can see anyone of them? أَوْ تَسْمَعُ لَهُمْ رِكْزَا. Or do you hear any whisper about them? So here ends Surah Maryam, and you might have noted that in this surah, the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mostly comes Ar-Rahman, Rahman, Rahman. So I have noted here that maybe this surah can be titled another Suratul Rahman. Suratul Rahman is there, Ar-Rahman wa 'allama al-Quran. But this name of Allah, Rahman, is not repeated there so many times as it has been repeated in this surah. Now we come to Surah Taha. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim, Taha. It is beginning with two letters. And they say that this is the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Yasin, they say it is the name of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Taha, this is also, they say, it's an opinion, although I don't agree with it. Anyhow, it's an opinion, I've told you. مَا أَنزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْقُرْآنَ لِتَشْقَى. Oh Muhammad, we have not sent down this Quran upon you so that you should be distressed or you should be a failure or doomed. Success will come to you. In the long run, you will be supreme. Your enemies, they will have to bow down before you. This Quran has come, as we have read in Surah Bani Israel. وَبِالْحَقِّ أَنزَلْنَاهُ وَبِالْحَقِّ نَزَلْ. This book has come down with the truth and the final decision it will give. People will be punished. They will get their chastisement. And Muhammad and his companions will triumph. إِلَّا تَذْكِرَةً لِمَنْ يَخْشَى. We have sent down it as an admonition, a reminding to those who fear. تَنزِيلًا مِمَّنْ خَلَقُ الْأَرْضَ وَالسَّمَاوَاتِ الْعُلَىٰ. And it has been sent down from the one who created the earth and all the heavens. which are very high. Ar-Rahmanu ala al-arshi istawa. Again, he Ar-Rahman. He is Ar-Rahman. He is the compassionate. And he has ascended the throne of this kingdom, of this universe. Lahu ma fi samawati wa ma fil ard. To him belongs whatever is in the heaven and whatever is in the earth. Wa ma baynahuma. And whatever is in between them. Wa ma taht as-sara. And whatever is beneath the soil, beneath this earth. Wa in tajhar bil qawl. Now if you want to talk to him loudly, you want to say your prayer loudly, fa innahu ya'lamu as-sirra wa akhfa. Okay, you can do it if you like so. But he knows every hidden thing, and even the most hidden thing, most secret things, he knows. He knows what you are saying to yourself in your heart. So you can talk to us heart to heart. It's not necessary that you use your tongue, but it's better to use the tongue. And you should raise the voice so that you hear also. So that, you know, your senses participate. More senses participate when you are communicating with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So your ears also should hear what you are saying. And that is why, you know, reading Quran from the Mushaf, it is more important than just by, you know, heart. A hafiz is only, you know, by his memory he is reading. No, it's more afzal to see, because now your eyes are also participating. They are seeing the text of the Quran. وَإِنْ تَجْهَرْ بِالْقَوْلِ فَإِنَّهُ يَعْلَمُ السِّرَّ وَأَخْفَى اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ لَهُ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah is He. There is no Lord except Him. And to Him belong all the good names, all the good attributes, all the good names. وَهَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَى. Now this surah is very unique. Just like Surah Yusuf. Surah Yusuf contains the story of one prophet from the beginning till the end. This is another example. It has 8 sections, but the 5 sections are devoted to the story of Moses alayhi salatu wasalam, Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. And there is a very interesting coincidence. With Yusuf alayhi salam is connected how the children of Israel entered Egypt. They entered Egypt in the time of Yusuf alayhi salam. And with Moses, they came out. So one full surah for Yusuf, we have already read, Surah to Yusuf. And nearly full surah, this is devoted to the history of Hazrat Musa. وَهَلْ أَتَاكَ حَدِيثُ مُوسَى. Has the news of Moses come to you? إِذْ رَعَى نَارًا. Now this is the incident when he was coming back from Madian. He had married there. He had served the Sheikh over there for 8 or 10 years. And then he had married his daughter. And now he was returning to Egypt. Remaining nearly for 10 years in exile. He had run away from Egypt because a person was killed. Unintentionally he was killed by him. But then, you know, the law could take its course. So he had to run for his life. So he came to Madian. And there, you know, he remained there for a sheikh. People say he was Shu'aib alayhi salatu wasalam. But some people differ, and I do differ. He's not Shu'aib. He was some other sheikh. And then now he was going back to Egypt with his family. In the way they were lost. It was a dark and very cold night. He and his family and some, you know, herd of the goats and sheep, he was going. Is Ran Haran. Suddenly he saw a fire. Faqala li ahlihi, so he said to his family, Imkusu, you stay here. Inni anastu nara, I have seen fire. La'alli atiku minha biqabasin, maybe that I bring to you from there a burning coal so that we can ignite a fire over here. Aw ajidu ala nari huda. And also it is possible that when I go there, where there is fire burning, then I can get guidance. We are lost. The way we shall know, which way we should go. فَلَمَّا أَتَاهَا. When he came to that bush from which, you know, fire was coming. نُودِيَ يَا مُوسَى. He was called by name, O Musa, Inni ana rabbuka fakhla na'alayk, I am your Lord. So take off your shoes. Innaka bilwadi al-muqaddas al-Tuwa, because you are now in the sacred valley of Tuwa. Wa ana akhtartuka, and I have chosen you for a mission. Fastami' lima yuha, so listen. What is being revealed to you, what is being said to you. Now, first of the revelations, a very grand way of expressing the Tawheed of Allah in this surah. Rather, I should say in the whole of Quran. Innani anallahu la ilaha illa ana fa'budni. I am the one. There is no God except me. So you have to worship me and obey me. Waqimi salata li zikri. And establish prayer for my remembrance. First command. Allama Iqbal calls it the big I am. Allah is also an ego, I. We have also an ego. I say I, you say I. But our ego, our self, is very small. Finite ego. And that is the infinite ego, the great I am. Innani anallahu la ilaha illa ana. He has this ayah in his mind when he says that. The great I am. In the Saat Atiyatun, number two, that fixed hour, the doomsday, is bound to come. Akadu khfiha, I will keep it hiding. Letujda kullu nafsim bima tasa, so that every person, every soul is rewarded fully for whatever he or she has endeavored. Fala yasuddannaka anha man la yu'minu biha. So see to it that whosoever does not believe in this akhirah, in this qiyamah, in this resurrection, he doesn't prevent you also from believing in it. Wattaba hawahu, and he is only following his lusts and desires of his id or libido. Fatarda, if you do this, you will perish. Wama tilka bi yameenika ya Musa, O Musa, what is that in your right hand? قَالَ هِيَ عَصَايَ, said, this is my staff. أَتَوَكَّوْ عَلَيْهَا, I lean on it. وَأَهُشُّ بِهَا عَلَىٰ غَنَمِي, and I beat down leaves for my goats, sheep. وَلِيَ فِيهَا مَعَارِبَ أُخْرَىٰ, and in this, I have other purposes to serve. This can be my weapon of defense for anybody if he attacks me, and so on and so forth. قَالَ أَلْقِهَا يَا مُوسَىٰ, Allah said, okay, throw it down. فَالْقَاهَا, he threw it down. فَإِذَا هِيَ حَيَّةٌ تَسْحَى, suddenly it became a serpent, a snake, running very fast. قَالَ خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ, at another place there is a mention. فَأَوْجَسَ فِي نَفْسِهِ خِيفَةً مُوسَى, Musa found in his heart خوف, fear. What has happened? A snake, a serpent. But Allah said, خُذْهَا وَلَا تَخَفْ, hold it back and don't fear. سَنُعِيدُهَا سِيرَتَهَا الْأُخْرَى, we shall restore it to its former state. وَضْمُمْ يَدَكَ إِلَىٰ جَنَاحِكَ, and press your hand towards your side. تَخْرُجْ بَيْضَىٰ, when you take it out, it will be white, shining. مِنْ غَيْرِ سُوءٍ آيَةً أُخْرَىٰ, this will be shining white like sun, but not due to any disease. And this is the second sign that we have given you. First, the staff changing into snake or serpent. Second, this hand, when he pressed it to his side and then took out, it was shining like a sun. لِنُرِيَكَ مِنْ آيَاتِنَا الْكُبْرَىٰ, and this was so as we should show you our big signs. And what is all this for? اِذْهَبْ إِلَىٰ فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّهُ تَغَىٰ, now go to Fir'aun, surely he has exceeded all bounds, all limits. He is arrogant, he is cruel, he is tyrant. So you have to go to him. قَالَ رَبِّ شْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي, now Musa prayed, O my Lord, open my chest for me. وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي, and make my mission easy for me. وَحْلُ الْعُقْدَةً مِنْ لِسَانِي, and lose the knot which is there in my tongue. Yafkahu qawli, so that they can understand what I say. Waj'alli waziram min ahli, and appoint from my own family a helper, a minister, Harun akhi, and I suggest he should be my brother Harun. Ushdud bihi adri, strengthen my back with him, with his support. Washiku fi amri, and associate him in my mission. Kay nusabbihka kaseera, so that we together, both of us, we glorify you much. Wa nazkuraka kaseera, and remember you much. Innaka kunta bina basira, verily you are seeing all our conditions. Qala qad utita sulaka ya Musa, Allah said, O Musa, your request is granted. وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى, and we had given you another blessing when we said to your mother what is being revealed now. Now when he was born, by the command and order of Fir'aun, all the male children were being slaughtered. So the mother of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, the wahi came to her that put this baby, you know, in a basket or something of that sort, a chest, and then put that chest in the Nile, in the river. So that is now Allah mentioning. وَلَقَدْ مَنَنَّا عَلَيْكَ مَرَّةً أُخْرَى, and we had conferred a very big favor on you once before also. Is أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ مَا يُوحَى, when we revealed to your mother what is being revealed to you now. أَنِ اغْزِفِيهِ بِالتَّابُوتُ, that cast him into a chest. فَغْزِفِيهِ فِي الْيَمُ, put that chest in the river. فَلْيُلْقِهِ الْيَمُّ بِالسَّاحِلِ, and this chest will throw it, this river will throw this chest on the coast of the river. يَأْخُذُهُ عَدُوٌّ لِي وَعَدُوٌّ لَهُ, and then he will be taken by a person who is my enemy and his enemy, Fir'aun. وَأَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي, and I endued you with love from me. There was a reflection of divine love on the face of Hazrat Musa. Whosoever saw him, he became loving him. So that is why he was saved. When you know the people of Fir'aun, they were deciding to kill him. They had recognized it's a Hebrew child. It's from Bani Israel. It was clear absolutely for them from the very beginning. But then, you know, the wife of Fir'aun, Bible says daughter of Fir'aun, but our tradition say wife of Fir'aun. He said, no, we shall take him, adopt him as our son. We don't have any son. They had no son till that time, Fir'aun and his wife. And this wife was also Israelite. So she has had love for the baby also. And then Quratun li wa lak, he will be a coolness of eyes for me and you. So when wife is requesting, and she was a beloved wife of Fir'aun, so he stopped. And himself, Musa, you know, he had that reflection of divine love. Whosoever saw him, he started loving him. وَأَلْقَيْتُ عَلَيْكَ مَحَبَّةً مِنِّي وَلَتُسْنَى عَلَىٰ عَيْنِي, so that you should be brought up before my eyes. إِسْتَمْشِي أُخْتُكَ, when your sister was walking, when you know the water of Nile was taking the chest, the sister was going on the coast and watching what happens. And when this chest reached the palace of Fir'aun, she went there. And she said, Istamshi ukhtuka fatakul hal adullukum ala man yakfuluh. Now what happened? Many women were called for suckling this child. He must have been someone to suckle him, but he never took, you know, in his own mouth, never took into the mammary gland of any woman in his mouth. Now it was a problem. How will he keep alive? Now the sister said, if you like, these details are given in other parts of Quran. You know, the mention of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam is the maximum in Quran. regarding all the prophets and the messengers of Allah. 1/13th of the whole Quran consists of the story of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. 555 ayat out of 6,500 ayat. They relate to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam. So she said, Hal adullukum ala man yakfulu? Should I lead to you a family? To you, that can keep this child for you. فَرَجَعْنَاكَ إِلَىٰ أُمِّكَ. In this way, we return you to your mother. كَيْتَقَرَّ عَيْنُهَا. So that her eyes remain cool. وَلَا تَحْزَنَ. And she should not grieve. وَقَتَلْتَ نَفْسًا. We shall read this story in detail in Suratul Qasas. But here, it's a summary. But then you killed a human being. فَنَجَّيْنَاكَ مِنَ الْغَمِّ. We saved you, delivered you from the grief. وَفَتَنَّاكَ فَتُونَا. And then we kept on trying you in different ways. فَلَبِسْتَ سِنِينَ فِي أَهْلِ مَدْيَنَ. Then you ran away from Egypt. You stayed with the people of Madian for a number of years. ثُمَّ جَئْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدَرٍ يَا مُوسَىٰ. And then you have come over here by the destiny that we fixed. You have not come yourself. It's the destiny, our destiny. We had decided it. We have been watching you through all this period. And we have prepared you. وَاسْتَنَعْتُكَ لِنَفْسِي. Very beautiful words. I have prepared you, chosen you for myself. So, a very heavy mission is going to be entrusted to you. ثُمَّ جَيْتَ عَلَىٰ قَدَرٍ يَا مُوسَىٰ. تَقْدِير. تَقْدِير has brought you over here. Our command. And we have prepared you specially for this purpose. إِذَا بَنْتَ بَأَخُوكَ بِآيَاتِ. Now go you and your brother with my signs, miracles. وَلَا تَنِيَا فِي ذِكْرِي. And don't be slack in remembering me. إِذْهَبَا إِلَىٰ فِرْعَوْنَ إِنَّهُ تَغَىٰ. Now go both of you to Fir'aun. Verily, he has become very tyrant. فَقُولَ لَهُ قَوْلًا لَيَّنًا. But say to him, you both, very gentle word. لَعَلَّهُ يَتَذَكَّرُهُ يَخْشَى. Maybe perchance he gets the admonition or he gets the fear of Allah in his heart. Don't be harsh. Talk to him gently. Now this is very important. A muballigh and da'i shouldn't be harsh. He should be very soft in his address. قَالَا رَبَّنَا إِنَّنَا نَخَافُ. Both of them said, Musa and Harun, O our Lord, we fear, أَنْ يَفْرُطَ عَلَيْنَا, that he might hasten against us. He might take any step against us. أَوْ أَنْ يَطْغَى, or he becomes a transgressor against us. قَالَ لَا تَخَافَا. Allah said, don't fear you both. إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا. Verily, I am with you. Don't fear. إِنَّنِي مَعَكُمَا أَسْمَعُ وَأَرَىٰ. I'll be listening to everything. I'll be seeing everything. فَاتِيَاهُ. Now go. Reach him. فَقُولَا. And both of you shall say, إِنَّا رَسُولَا رَبِّكَ. We both are the messengers of your Lord. فَأَرْسِلْ مَعَنَا بَنِي إِسْرَائِيلِ. Now allow the children of Israel to go with us. They are not the sons of this soil. They came from Palestine in the time of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. And they were settled here by the king of that time. And Hazrat Yusuf also was the Aziz of Misr, was a big authority in that kingdom. But now nearly 400 years had passed. That was actually the time of the Hyksos kings. These were not the, he was not a Fir'aun. He was not a local Egyptian king at the time of Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. They were the Hyksos kings, Amalites, Amalqa. Amalqa had invaded Egypt and they were reigning at the time of Hazrat Yusuf alayhi salatu wasalam. And they were from the Arabian desert. So actually they welcomed Bani Israel, settled here. And they, you know, favored them. So they prospered. It's a 12 families had reached over there. And after 400 years, they were 600,000 in number at the time of Exodus. 1400 years before Christ. Nearly 400 or 500 years had passed. And they prospered and multiplied in number. So now, but then there was a revolt against those Hyksos kings. They were, you know, beaten away. And now it was the local, son of the soil. Now they were the Egyptians who were ruling, the Pharaon dynasty. So now they were against these Bani Israel because they were the favorites of the former kings. So now this is the nationalism, simple nationalism. Just as you know, the Biharis in East Pakistan, in the same way, these Bani Israel were treated as foreigners and they were, you know, persecuted like anything. Now Hazrat Musa said, let them go back. Don't persecute them. Inna Rasula Rabbika. Fakula inna Rasula Rabbika farsil maana Bani Israel wala tu'azzibhum. Don't persecute them. Qad jaynaka bi ayatin min Rabbik. And look, we have come to you with a sign from your Lord. Wassalamu ala mani taba al huda. And peace would be upon them, upon those who follow the guidance. If you follow, if you accept what we are saying, then there will be peace for you. Inna qad uhiya ilayna. This has been revealed to us. Annal azaba, that the chastisement would come. Ala man kazzaba wa tawalla. Whosoever belies us and whosoever turns his face away from what we are saying. Qala famar rabbukuma ya Musa. Now Fir'aun asks, who is your Lord, O Musa? I don't know any Lord except myself. I am the Lord of Egypt. Ana rabbukum al-ala. I am the Lord of Egypt. Alaysa li mulku Misr wa hadhihi al-anharu tajri min tahti. Is not the kingdom and government of Egypt under me? And all the irrigation system is controlled by me? Who is this your Lord who has sent you? Qala famar rabbukum ya Musa. And please remember, Musa was like an elder brother to this Fir'aun. Because this Fir'aun now, he was the son of that Fir'aun in whose time Hazrat Musa as an infant came to that mahal, that palace. But later on, Allah gave him also a son. And this was his real son. But when Moses was also there in the palace, so they too were like brothers. This Fir'aun was like younger brother to Hazrat Musa. Hazrat Musa was like elder brother to this Fir'aun. Because now the old Fir'aun, you know, he had abdicated due to old age. And he had given over the government to this son of his. So this son of his, who was like a younger brother to Musa alayhi salatu wasalam, now this conversation is going between them. Qala famar rabbukum ya Musa. Who is your Lord, O Moses? Qala rabbuna alladhi aata kulla shay'in khalqahu summa hada. Hazrat Musa said, our Lord is the one who gave every creation its existence and then guided it. Qala fama balul quruni lula. A very intelligent question that he put. Then what will happen to the former generations? If you are true, if a true Lord God has sent you, maybe I accept you and I will be saved. What about my father and my forefathers and my grandfather? What will happen to them? Now, if we were there, we would say they are all in the hell. But Moses didn't say that. So what he said? قَالَ عِلْمُهَا عِنْدَ رَبِّي فِي كِتَابٍ. The knowledge of the former generations is with my Lord in a book. لَا يَضِلُّ رَبِّي وَلَا يَنْسَى. My Lord neither errs nor forgets. What about you? I have come to you. Talk about yourself. أَلَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُمُ الْأَرْضَ بَهْدًا. Our Lord is the one who has made this land for you as cradle. وَسَلَكَ لَكُمْ فِيَا سُبُلَىٰ. And threaded in this earth pathways for you. وَأَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. And sent down from the heaven water. فَأَخْرَجْنَا بِهِ أَزْوَاجًا مِّن نَبَاتٍ شَتَّىٰ. And with this water, we have brought out from this earth all the plants of different kinds. Kulu, eat you, war'an amakum, and pasture your cattle also. Inna fi zalika la ayatil li ulil nuha. In this are the signs for those people who have the faculty of reasoning. Minha khalaqnakum. From this earth we have created you. Wa fiha nu'idukum. And to this earth we shall take you again. When you die, you will be buried in it. Wa minha nukhrijukum taratan ukhra. And from this earth we shall take you out once more. Wa laqad araynahu ayatina kullaha fakazzaba wa aba. We showed to him, to Fir'aun, all the signs. But he denied all them, belied them and refused to accept. Qala jaitana li tukhrijana min ardina bi sahrika. Min ardina bi sahrika ya Musa. He said, oh Musa, have you come so as you want to drive us out of this land of ours with your sorcery? Falanatiyannaka bi sahrin mislihi. So now we shall confront you with sorcery of this type. We shall call magicians. And you will have to have, you know, a test. فَجْعَلْ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكَ مَوْعِدًا. So fix a time between you and us. لَا نُخْلِفُهُ نَحْنُ. Neither we shall go back on that, وَلَا أَنْتَ. And also you don't go back for that fixed time. مَكَانًا سُوَا. And this should be in a very open ground. People should gather. You should produce what you have. You say these are miracles from Allah. We say this is magic. This is sorcery. Now we are calling our magicians. And now you will have to play a match against them. قَالَ مَوْعِدُكُمْ يَوْمَ الزِّينَةِ. He said, okay. The time fixed for you is the day of our annual feast. Maybe some Eid they used to celebrate. وَأَنْ يُحْشَرَ النَّاسُ ضُحَى. And call that people should gather before noon. فَتَوَلَّى فِرْعَوْنُ. So Fir'aun turned his back. فَجَمَعَ كَيْدَهُ. And he gathered and devised the plot and all the scheme. ثُمَّ أَتَى. And then came for the confrontation. Now people have gathered, thousands of them. Open field. Fir'aun is there. His chieftains are there. On the other side, Musa and Harun are standing. And there are some magicians which have been, you know, brought from all the corners of the whole country. قَالَ لَهُمْ مُوسَى وَيْلَكُمْ. Musa said to them, to the magicians, وَيْلَكُمْ لَا تَفْتَرُوا عَلَى اللَّهِ كَذِبًا. Woe to you. Don't forge a lie against Allah. فَيُسْحِتَكُمْ. So that there comes an azab. يُسْحِتَكُمْ بِعَذَابٍ. He exterminate you with a chastisement. وَقَدْ خَابَ مَنْ افْتَرَى. And definitely whosoever forges a lie, he is to lose. فَتَنَازَعُوا أَمْرَهُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ. Now this speech of Musa alayhi salatu wasalam impressed them. So they now debated. There was difference. Some said we should go and confront him. Others said no. He doesn't seem to be a magician. He seems to be something else. So it's not good for us to go and confront him. فَتَنَازَعُوا أَمْرَهُمْ بَيْنَهُمْ وَأَسَرُّ النَّجْوَى. They debated their matter among them and they secretly counseled and consulted each other. قَالُوا. Now Fir'aun and his chieftains said to these magicians, sorcerers, قَالُوا إِنْ هَذَانِ لَسَاحِرَانِ يُرِيدَانِ أَنْ يَخْرُجَاكُمْ مِنْ أَرْضِكُمْ بِسِحْرِهِمَا وَيَذْهَبَا بِطَرِيقَتِكُمُ الْمُسْلَى. He said, these two persons, Musa and Harun, they are nothing but two magicians, sorcerers. And they want to drive you out from your land, your country, with their magic and sorcery. And they want to finish your ideal culture and social order. A very political speech which Fir'aun made. Our culture is ideal. Our system, our kingdom, our traditions. Now these two persons, you know, they have learned some magic from somewhere and they want that we should be in awe. We should run and give the land to them. فَأَجْمِعُوا كَيْدَكُمْ. So gather all your skills. ثُمَّ أَتُوا صَفَّا. and then come as a rank before them. وَقَدْ أَفْلَحَ الْيَوْمَ مَنِ اسْتَعَلَىٰ. And today, whosoever succeeds, then he is actually who is above everything, everyone. قَالُوا. Now the magicians came forward on this persuasion. قَالُوا يَا مُوسَىٰ. They said, O Musa, إِمَّا أَن تُلْقِيَ وَإِمَّا أَن نَكُونَ أَوَّلَ مَنْ أَلْقَىٰ. Will you cast down first? Or should we be the first to cast down? You produce what you have, or we produce what we have. قَالَ بَلْ أَلْقُوْ. Musa said, okay, you go ahead and you present what you have. Cast down. فَإِذَا حِبَالُهُمْ وَعِسِيُّهُمْ يُخَيَّلُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ سَهْرِهِمْ أَنَّهَا تَسْعَى. Suddenly, their ropes and their staffs appeared to Musa alayhi salam as if they are moving like snakes. The same thing, the staff of Musa becoming a snake. But with this sorcery also, they produce some effect on the sight of the people. You see, we call nazar bandi. Somehow they could capture the sight of the people, and it appeared to them, including Musa alayhi salam. He also thought that these are moving snakes. فَأَوْجَسَ فِي نَفْسِهِ خِيفَةً مُوسَىٰ. So Musa conceived a fear in his mind. قُلْنَا لَا تَخَفْ إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَلَىٰ. We said, don't have any fear. You will be supreme. وَأَلْقِ مَا فِي يَمِينِكَ. Now you cast what you have in your right hand. تَلْقَفُ مَا صَنَعُوا. It will swallow everything that they have produced. إِنَّمَا صَنَعُوا كَيْدُ سَاحِرٍ. What they have presented is only the presentation and skill of a sorcerer. وَلَا يُفْلِحُ السَّاحِرُ حَيْثُ أَتَىٰ. And a sorcerer and a magician cannot be successful from where, whichever side he might have come. وَأُلْقِيَ السَّحْرَةُ سُجَّدًا. Now the magicians or the sorcerers were as if made to bow down. Ulqiya, this is majhul, not maruf. Not that the magicians bowed down and prostrated, but it appeared as if someone had compelled them to bow down. فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحْرَةُ سُجَّدًا. In prostration. قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ هَارُونَ وَمُوسَىٰ. And they said, we believe in the Lord of Harun and Musa. Now why? This is very important to understand. The magicians very well knew the limits of the magic. Just as a scientist today knows what is the limit to which our science has reached. If there is some big leap, well, they would say it is something unnatural or supernatural. They know the limits. Limits of the sciences, limits of the technologies. Maybe tomorrow you go forward, but today there is a limit. You can't cross that limit. So now the common people couldn't differentiate, because they saw it's the same thing, the staff of Musa turning into a serpent and the ropes and staffs of these magicians turning into snakes. What's the difference? So for a layman, there was no difference. But for the magicians and the sorcerers, they knew the difference, that this is not sorcery, it is something else. Shay digar hai, it's something else. فَأُلْقِيَ السَّحْرَةُ سُجَّدًا. قَالُوا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّ مُوسَىٰ هَارُونَ وَمُوسَىٰ. We come to believe in the Lord of Harun and Moses. قَالَ آمَنْتُمْ لَهُ قَبْلَ أَنْ أَذَنَ لَكُمْ. Now Firaun said, you come to believe in him before I allow you to do it? I'm the king, I'm the emperor. How dare you without my permission? And you are declaring that you believe in Moses? إِنَّهُ لَكَبِيرُكُمْ. Now this is the diplomacy. A politician as he was. Now he suddenly has this idea. A very intelligent idea. إِنَّهُ لَكَبِيرُكُمْ الَّذِي عَلَّمَكُمُ السِّحْرَ. Actually this Musa is your guru. Is your teacher who has taught you this magic. And now this is your collaboration. You have done this with mutual understanding. فَلَأُقَطِّعَنَّ أَيْدِيَكُمْ. I will chop away your hands. وَأَرْجُلَكُمْ. And your feet. مِنْ خِلَافٍ. From opposite sides. وَلَأُصَلِّبَنَّكُمْ فِي جُزُوعِ النَّخْلِ And then I shall crucify you in the trunks of the palm trees. وَلَتَعْلَمُنَّ أَيُّنَا أَشَدُّ عَذَابًا وَأَبْقَى And you will come to know who amongst us, me or Musa, they are more in chastisement and more abiding. قَالُوا لَن نُسِرَكَ عَلَى مَا جَانَا مِنَ الْبَيِّنَاتِ They said, we are not going to prefer you over what clear teaching has come to us. We have come to see the truth. This is not magic. This is not sorcery. This is something else. Now this truth has dawned on us. Now your threats, they can't prevent us. Lannu siraka ala ma jana. Whatever has come to us from these bayyanat, we are not going to prefer you to them. Wallazi fatarana. And we are not going to prefer to you to the one who created us. Faqziba anta qaz. So you command whatever command you want to make. Innama takhzi hadhihi alhayat ad-dunya. You can take any decision only for this life of this world. What will you do? Kill us? Okay. We have to die. If not today, tomorrow. If not tomorrow, day after. Kill us. But that life is the everlasting life. We are not going to barter it away for this temporary abode of this world. إِنَّمَا تَغْزِي هَذِهِ الْحَيَاةَ الدُّنْيَا إِنَّا آمَنَّا بِرَبِّنَا لِيَغْفِرَ لَنَا خَطَايَانَا We believe in our Lord so that He forgives us our discrepancies and sins. وَمَا أَكْرَحْتَنَا عَلَيْهِ مِنَ السَّهِرِ And you know, you compelled us to come and confront Musa in this, you know, test of this magic. وَاللَّهُ خَيْرٌ وَأَبْقَى Allah is the one who is much better. Much higher, and he is the one who will remain, who is abiding. Innahu man yati rabbahu mujriman. Verily, whosoever comes to his Lord as an evil doer, fa inna lahu jahannama yamut la yamutu fiha wa la yahya. For him will be hell. In that, in the hell, he will not be living, nor death will come. Between life and death, neither living nor dead. لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا ومن ياته مؤمنا and whosoever comes to him as a mu'min, as a believer قد عمل الصالحات but note everywhere where there is a mention of iman عمل الصالح is also mentioned whosoever comes to him while he was a mu'min, he was a believer but not only a mu'min قد عمل الصالحات he had done good deeds فأولئك لهم الدرجات العلا For them will be very high ranks in the paradise. Jannatu adnin tajri min tahtil anhar. Gardens of perpetuity and bliss. And rivers will be flowing underneath them. Khalidina fiha and they will remain there forever. Wazalika jazau man tazakka. And this is going to be the reward of those who purify their souls. Walakad ahina ila Musa. Now, A long time has passed. This was the first confrontation. Now so many years have passed. This confrontation between Musa on the one side and Firaun on the other side. Now the last, the end. وَلَقَدْ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَىٰ مُوسَىٰ We revealed and sent a revelation, command to Musa through wahi an asra bi'ibadi that you go out with my bondsmen, Bani Israel. In the night, leave the place. There was a program chalked out at certain date, at certain that time, we shall all come out and go towards Sinai. Anasri bi'ibadi, faglib lahum tariqan fil bahre yabasa, and strike for them a dry path in the sea. La takhafu darkan wala takhsha, don't fear that you will be overtaken. And don't be afraid. فَأَتْبَعَهُمْ فِرْعَوْنُ بِجُنُودِهِ Now Fir'aun followed them with his armies, hosts. فَغَشِيَهُمْ مِنَ الْيَمِّ مَا غَشِيَهُمْ Then covered them from that sea, what covered them? When they were drowned, water was covering them. So Musa and Bani Israel crossed the sea or river, whatever it was. There is one opinion that it was one of the salt lakes there were lakes, you know, between this Gulf of Suez in the south and the Mediterranean Sea. And lakes were there at different intervals. When the Suez Canal was dug, actually only this lake and this lake, intervening part of the area was dug. And the lakes were joined together so that a water channel come into existence. So one of the salt lakes, it is one opinion, they crossed it. فَغَشِيَهُمْ مِنَ الْيَمِّ مَا غَشِيَهُمْ وَعَضَلَّ فِرْعَوْنُ قَوْمَهُ وَمَا هَدَىٰ. And Fir'aun led his people astray and didn't guide them to the right path. Ya Bani Israel, now the address is to the children of Israel who have been saved. Ya Bani Israel, قَدْ أَنْجَيْنَاكُمْ مِنْ عَدُوِّكُمْ. We have saved you and delivered you from your enemy. وَوَعَدْنَاكُمْ جَانِبِ الطُّورِ الْأَيْمَنَىٰ. And we called you for a covenant to the right side of the Mount Tur. وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكُمُ الْمَنَّ وَالسَّلْوَىٰ. And we sent down on you for your dietary needs the man and salwa. Man was some honeydew type of, you know, dew came down and then hardened. So it provided them the carbohydrates. And salwa was a bird. Flocks of those birds came down. So they very easily hunted them. So meat was provided by salwa and carbohydrates by man. They say that in the ark, which according to the Jews is still present, in a tunnel beneath Al-Qubbatu Sakhra in Jerusalem, and in that ark, Sunduq al-Sakina, there is a pot of man. Man is there, a sample is there in that ark, up till this date. كُلُوا مِن طَيِّبَاتِ مَا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ. Eat of the pure things that we have given you. There cannot be anything purer than this food which was coming from them. وَلَا تَطْغَوْ فِيهِ. And don't cross the limits for them. Don't try to hoard them and collect them. But use it and you fulfill your requirements. فَيَهِلَّ عَلَيْكُمْ غَضَبِي. So then, you know, my chastisement will descend upon you. وَمَنْ يَحْلِلْ عَلَيْهِ غَضَبِي فَقَدْ هَوَىٰ. And on whomsoever my chastisement comes, then he perishes, he is doomed. وَإِنِّي لَغَفَّارٌ لِمَنْ تَعْبَىٰ. And we are, and I am definitely forgiving for those مَنْ تَعْبَىٰ, who repent, وَآمَنَىٰ, and renew their iman, belief, وَعَمِلَ صَالِحًا, and they do good deeds, ثُمَّ اهْتَدَىٰ, and then they are rightly guided. مَا عَجَلَكَ عَنْ قَوْمِكَ يَا مُوسَىٰ. Now Hazrat Musa was called to Tur again to give him Torah. And it was for 30 days or 40 days. He fasted for 40 days. And then Torah was given to him. But when he reached there, before the appointed time, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala demanded an explanation. Why have you come before the appointed time? وَمَا عَجَلَكَ عَنْ قَوْمِكَ يَا مُوسَىٰ. O Musa, what has made you hasten from your people? قَالَ هُمْ أُولَاءِ عَلَىٰ أَثَرِي. He said, they are close upon my track. وَعَجِلْتُ إِلَيْكَ رَبِّ لِتَرْضَىٰ. And I have come to you earlier, O my Lord, so that you are pleased with me. تُو میرا شوق دیکھ, میرا اشتیاق دیکھ, I have come earlier due to your love. I hoped that you will, you know, pay tribute to me, that I have come earlier. But here the matter is reverse. You are asking an explanation. قَالَ فَإِنَّا قَدْ فَتَنَّا قَوْمَكَ مِنْ بَعْدِكَ. Now this is a very important point in Quran. Even for something good, you should not make haste. الْعُجْلَةُ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ. We have read in Surah Taha, Surah Maryam, لَا تَعْجَلْ عَلَيْهِمْ. Don't be hasty regarding these people. Don't want a hasty decision. A hasty command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَا تَعَجَلْ بِالْقُرْآنِ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يُقْضَىٰ إِلَيْكَ وَحْيُهُ. Don't demand that Quran should come to you hastily. No. We have read in Surah Maryam that the Prophet complained to Hazrat Jibreel, you are coming with very late, long intervals. You should come earlier. And he said, مَا نَتَنَزَّلُ إِلَّا بِأَمْرِ رَبِّكَ لَهُ مَا بَيْنَ أَيْدِينَا وَمَا خَلْفَنَا وَمَا بَيْنَ ذَلِكَ قَالَ فَإِنَّا قَدْ فَتَنَّا قَوْمَكَ مِنْ بَعْدِكَ. Allah said, we have tempted your people after you. وَعَضَلَّهُمُ السَّامِرِي, and Samri has led them astray to worship the calf which he produced. فَرَجَعَ مُوسَى إِلَىٰ قَوْمِهِ غَزْبَانَ آسِفًا. So Musa returned to his people when he was indignant, sorrowing. قَالَ يَا قَوْمِ أَلَمْ يَعِدْكُمْ رَبُّكُمْ وَعَدًا حَسَنًا. He said, oh my people, did not your Lord promise you a goodly promise? أَفَتَالَ عَلَيْكُمُ الْعَهَدُ. Has this time been very long upon you? أَمْ أَرَدْتُمْ أَنْ يَحِلَّ عَلَيْكُمْ غَضَبٌ. Or you want that Allah's chastisement should come to you, مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ, from your Lord. فَأَخْلَقْتُمْ مُعَيْدِي, and then you did against what I had said to you. قَالُوا مَا أَخْلَفْنَا مُعَيْدَكَ بِمَلْكِنَا. They said, we failed not in your appointment with our own intentions. وَلَكِنَّا هُمِّلْنَا أَوْزَارًا مِنَ ذِنَّةِ الْقَوْمِ. But we were being laden by the ornaments of the people. In Egypt, the Egyptians used to keep their ornaments with Bani Israel, that these are honest people, so as amana in their custody. Now when they came, they brought all those ornaments with them. But then they thought that this is khayana, this is not correct for us, so they threw it. Samri collected all the gold and silver and melted it in fire. And from that, he created the shape of a calf, which gave a voice also, a sound also. And he said, he is the Lord of Moses. He just forgot. So they started, some of them, worshipping him. قَالُوا مَا أَخْلَفْنَا مَوْعِدَكَ بِمَلْكِنَا وَلَاكِنَّا هُمِّلْنَا أَوْزَارًا مِنْ زِينَةِ الْقَوْمِ. We were laden with the ornaments of the people. فَقَذَفْنَا, then we threw them. فَقَذَلِكَ أَلْقَ السَّامِرِي. In the same way Samri did it. فَأَخْرَجَ لَهُمْ عِجْلًا. And then he formed from that, for them, a calf, jasadan, had a body of calf, lahu khuar, giving a low also. فَقَالُوا هَذَا إِلَاهُكُمْ وَإِلَاهُ مُوسَى فَنَسِي. And he said, this is the Lord, your Lord and Lord of Moses, Lord of Musa, but he just forgot. أَفَلَا يَرَوْنَا. Didn't they see? أَلَّا يَرْجَعُ إِلَيْهِمْ قَوْلًا. That calf was not returning them, not talking to them, not replying to their questions. وَلَا يَمْلِكُ لَهُمْ ضَرًّا وَلَا نَفْعًا. And had no authority for them, for any good or any harm. بارك الله لي ولكم في القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بالآيات والذكر الحكيم.